Hello everyone, beginning with our project name. The name of our project is Microwave Oven. The group members who has worked on this project are Asif Hazan, Harichandana, Shivam Kumar Tiwari. In this project we are going to discuss about some basic C programming, microcontroller, embedded program based microwave oven. So first and foremost, let us look into C. Why we use C? Because C reduces the gap between high and low level languages, and C has very few libraries. So this helps us building analytical skills, because you won't be dependent on programming language entirely for implementing basic functions, and moreover you can implement them on your own. Next, C is fast in terms of execution time. Coming to features of C, C is a procedural language, and it has libraries with rich functions. It is easy to extend, and it has a capability of modules. Coming to keywords, the list of keywords are here. Char, int, float, double, signed, unsigned, short, long, etc. are some of the keywords. Coming to data representation, data can be represented using bits, bytes and words. Bit is a basic function, a basic unit of information in computer and digital communication. Number is generally represented in the form of decimal, octal, hexadecimal, binary. Coming to the data types, here is a list of data types such as signed char, unsigned char, short signed int, short unsigned int, signed int, unsigned int, etc. And these are the ranges, and these are the bytes. Generally this data type is used, and this is the format of the data type. Coming to the conditional constructs, there are two types of conditional constructs here. One is if else and the other is switch. Coming to if else has four types: if else if and nested if. Coming to switch, switch has two statements, case and break. In if else we write the condition in if, and we can use the else to represent the controversial conditions. Coming to operators, here are few types of operators: unary, arithmetic, relational, logical, bitwise, assignment and ternary or conditional operators. Here are the few basic examples on arithmetic operators written in C. Coming to arrays, arrays are the sequence of objects which are of same data type. When we give an elements in the form of array, those elements will be allocating in the continuous memory locations like this. The first element will be in the lowest address, and the last element will be in the highest address. So if you want to store the elements, we use arrays. Arrays can be declared and initialized. Coming to declaring arrays, arrays are declared using type array and array size. Coming to we can initialize arrays by giving directly the elements. We can also access the array elements. Here it is an example regarding double salary equal to balance of 9, and this statement will take 10th element from the array and assign the value to this salary variable, and this salary is here of double type. Here is an example of array. Coming to the pointer, pointer can store the address of variables or a memory, and this can be declared as data type star variable name. The features of pointers are, pointers can be used for file handling and to allocate the memory dynamically. And here is an example on pointer. Coming to the storage, all computers do not store the bytes that comprise of a multi-byte value in the same order, and there are two ways to store. One is big Indian, and the other one is little Indian. In big Indian representation, higher order byte is stored on the starting address and the lower order byte is stored in the next address. In Little Endian, the higher order byte is stored in the next address and the lower order byte is stored in the starting address. Now let's step into the microcontrollers. In microcontrollers, we can discuss about what is basic microcontroller, what is embedded system, and then we can go into embedded programming. Coming to the introduction to microcontrollers, we'll study about microcontroller and its peripherals here and how to use a microcontroller. A microcontroller is a small computer on a single metal oxide semiconductor integrated unit or a chip. It contains a CPU along with a memory and with some programmable input-output peripherals. So a microcontroller can be used to perform a specific task based on the instruction set and capabilities. Coming to the elements and applications of microcontroller, CPU, RAM, ROM, input and output ports, clock, counter, timers, etc. These are the peripherals of the microcontroller. Coming to the applications, microcontroller can be used in a TV remote, setup box, micro oven, which is used in our kitchen, washing machine, air conditioner, etc. So let's come into choosing a microcontroller. So there are few key factors to choose a microcontroller. First one is power efficiency, next processing power, temperature tolerance, memory, hardware architecture, etc. So now let us step into embedded system. An embedded system is a combination of hardware and software using which we are intended to perform a specific task. So it's a combination of computer processor, computer memory, input-output peripherals. It is a part of a complete device, often including electrical or electronic hardware and mechanical parts. Because an embedded system typically controls physical operations of the machine that it is embedded within, it has often real-time computing constraints also. Coming to the examples, embedded systems are traffic lights, mobile phone, tablets, aeroplane, refrigerator, air conditioner, all these are types of, all these are made using the embedded system. There are categories in embedded systems. Based on the functional requirements, they are classified as real-time embedded system, standalone embedded system, networked embedded system, mobile embedded system. Coming to the components, there are three types of components. It has a hardware, application software, and real-time operating system. This real-time operating system defines the way that system works. It sets the rules during the execution of application program. Coming to the requirements, there are two types of requirements here, functional requirements and non-functional requirements. Coming to the functional requirements, input-output processing, and non-functional requirements are reliability, maintainability, portability, security, time to market, and cost. Coming to the trends in development, more computing power and new architectures are coming into existence, low power consumption, more security, more robustness, connectivity, more local autonomy. These are the common design metrics of embedded system: a unit cost, NRE cost, size, power performance, and flexibility. So now coming into the embedded programming. Embedded programming is also known as embedded software development or embedded systems programming. So it is a specific type of programming that supports the creation of consumer-facing or business-facing devices that don't operate on traditional operating systems. So let us come into our main part of this project, embedded system-based microwave oven. In this, we can see about introduction to microwave oven, block diagram, working, tools required, embedded program, simulation and result, applications, and finally advantages and disadvantages. Coming to the microwave oven, it is a kitchen appliance that heats and cooks food. It generally converts the electrical energy into a form of electromagnetic energy. So it's a basic block diagram of microwave oven. It contains LCD panel, LEDs and few switches. It's known as a key matrix. And a power circuit, BD converters. Now let's step into the working. Microwave oven works on the principle of conversion of electromagnetic energy into thermal energy. Electromagnetic energy refers to the radiation comprising an electrical field and the magnetic field oscillating perpendicular to each other. So when a polar molecule falls into the part of these electromagnetic radiations, it oscillates to align with them. This causes the energy to be lost from the dipole by molecular friction and collision, and this results in heating. The water molecules present inside of food products go under a similar phenomenon, where they come into contact with the microwave radiations and the food will be thus heated. In microwave, 2.24 GHz frequency is used. So coming to tools required, these are the following tools required to simulate microwave oven. This is MPLAB X IDE. This is a development tool, development environment. Coming to MPLAB X8 compiler, it's a cross compiler, and PixSim Lab Simulator as a simulating tool. So now let's look into MPLAB X IDE. This is basically an MPLAB X IDE looks, and it's version of 5.50. And here we can, in order to create a new project, we will go into file and we will create a new project. And after going into it, when we click, otherwise we can click on new file to get a new file, and so that a blank empty new file will be created in order to write program. So this is basically a MPLAB X IDE. Now coming into the X8 compiler, it is a cross compiler and a simulating tool. This is a PixSim Lab simulating tool. Coming to MPLAB X IDE, it is used for embedded system development with PIC microcontrollers. And it is a product from Microchip. And coming to the MPLAB X8 compiler, since MPLAB IDE does not have any default compiler, we have to install a compiler. Here we have installed X8 compiler. Slash include xc.h contain. It is a header file which contains all the definitions of all the registers of PIC microcontroller. The PIC microcontroller we used here is PIC 16F877A. Now it's a basic architecture of PIC microcontroller, PIC 16F877A. It has analog to digital converter, LEDs, buzzer, digital keypad, CLCD, matrix keypad, etc. The PixSim Lab, it is a real-time emulator of development boards. Emulator is a target board. It is used to simulate the function of the application which we are going to develop. So before designing and developing the actual device, we use emulator to just simulate the results. Coming into PixSim Lab PIC microcontroller, we have the following peripherals: timers, clock, input output, CLCD, matrix keypad, etc. Coming into an LED, this is the basic peripheral we use in this project. It is the simplest device and we can find it almost everywhere. Home lighting, remote controls, It generally consumes a very less energy and the longer life. It is used as a feedback element. So this is how the LEDs look can be looked on the board. Coming to character liquid crystal display, CLCDs, it is a liquid crystal display, a mode of display used in digital equipment, which displays the current status and remaining time while heating the food in microwave oven. And this is how it looks on the circuit. Coming to tactile switch, it is a switch whose operation is perceptible by touch. And if we touch here, it immediately gets contact to the metal plate. And these are the terminals. And this is the basic circuit of tactile switch. Coming to matrix keypad, it has 16 buttons. So each button is given as an input to the microcontroller. And this is how it looks on matrix keypad, keypad looks on board. So coming to timers, it is timers are basically used to indicate the time required for a microwave oven to cook. So we will set the time initially, how much time required to cook. So here microwave timer operates as a minute timer. Coming to cooking modes, we have two modes mainly. One is standard and the other one is convection. In standard mode, it uses microwaves to heat or cook the food. In second mode, it is a convection mode. It transforms the microwave into a convection oven, which uses the heating element and a fan to evenly distribute the heat throughout the appliance. Now let's step into the interrupts. An interrupt is a communication process set up in a microprocessor or a microcontroller. So they can be external and internal. Any external or internal device requests the microprocessor unit to stop processing. So the microprocessor unit acknowledges the request, it attends to the request and goes back to the processing where it was interrupted. So interrupts are two types, hardware interrupt and software interrupt. Again, hardware interrupt is divided into maskable interrupt and non-maskable interrupt. Coming to interrupt handling, first there will be few instructions in our main program. The processor executes all these, and when an interrupt occurred, it saves the next instruction address into the program controller and it goes to the interrupt service routine. It executes the instructions in the interrupt service routine and it will return to the program controller and to the address in the program controller where it has stopped initially and executes the main program instructions. So it's how interrupt handling happens. Coming to the in handling multiple devices, there are three methods: polling, vectored, and interrupt nesting. Now let's go into the embedded program. It is a software submit a zip file in order to, according to the program, we have a microwave oven embedded system which interfaces with the external environment by means of several sensors and interface. It supports a simple user interface, keeps a track of time and provides centralized control that necessitates the design of a state machine. So let's go into the program of our LED. So here it is the program which we write for LED will be stored in the source file. It is main.c file. So in main.c, this is the header file /include.xc.h. So coming to TRISP, it is a direction of port B. It is selected as 0. So if it is selected as 0, it is an output. If it is 1, and then the port B access an input. Coming to port B, it is all set to 0. So the initially the LEDs will be off, in off state. Coming to this, an unsigned int I is declared while one. We will go into the loop, while loop. So port B, it is initialized with zeros and ones here. So we have written a for loop for the delay. Since if we don't indicate the delay here, we can't recognize or we can't notice how the LEDs were glowing. It takes very little time for the LED to glow. So let's dump this into the PixSim lab. So here is PixSim lab. Before dumping, we have to save this and we have to build. So here we will get like a building. This build is successful, and here this indicates the path of the hex file. So we have to upload this hex file into the PixSim lab. So let's load the hex file. Going into file, load hex. So we have to go back to know where the file is exactly located, hex file. So we have to go to C users HP. So let's go there. Local disk C users HP, and here MPX lab projects LED. Later dist default production. And here it is hex file. So we will load into this. So we could see here LEDs, all the LEDs were glowing. All the 8 LEDs were glowing here, and these are all off because we didn't program for port D. We have programmed for port B LEDs, so they were glowing. So this is how we will execute program for LED. Now let's go back to the slides. Coming to the output, we have seen it already. These are the program for timer, and when we write all the program for different interfaces, timer, CLCD, matrix, keypad, we will finally get the output. Let's step into advantages and disadvantages. Coming to advantages of microwave oven, cooking time will be short here and no physical exchange of foods, and here melting process is very easy. There is no flame, so treatment is very easy. Coming to the disadvantages, in closed container, it may be dangerous sometimes or it may be burst, so we should be careful with this. Coming to the applications, microwave ovens are very popular in reheating previously cooked foods and cooking vegetables. So they are already used in many industries for making chocolate and for some other purposes. So let's end here. In conclusion, microwave processing technology required to learn and understand. Microwave oven will update accordingly to the technology, and most likely candidates for future production scale applications will take full advantage of the unique characteristics of microwaves. So thanks for giving this opportunity to learn about microwave application oriented embedded programming. Thank you.